tax returns. Let me bring this to Speaker Gingrich. Earlier this week, you said Governor Romney, after he released his taxes, you said that you were satisfied with the level of transparency of his personal finances when it comes to this. And I just want to reiterate and ask you, are you satisfied right now with the level of transparency as far as his personal finances?
Well, you and I have a great relationship. It goes back a long way. I'm with him. This is a nonsense question. Look, how about if the four of us agree for the rest of the evening, we'll actually talk about issues that relate to governing America.
Mr. Speaker, you made an issue of this week when you said that he lives in a world of Swiss bank and Cayman Island bank accounts. I didn't say that. You did.
I did, and I'm perfectly happy to say that on an interview on some TV show, but this is a national debate where you have a chance to get the four of us to talk about a whole range of issues.
But if you make a serious accusation against Governor Romney like that, you need to explain that.
You want to try again? I mean,
wouldn't it be nice if people didn't make accusations somewhere else that they weren't willing to defend here?
Okay. All right. Okay. Given that standard, Mitt, I did say I thought it was unusual, and I don't know of any American president who's had a Swiss bank account. I'd be glad for you to explain that sort of thing.
Okay. I will. I'll say it again. I have a trustee that manages my investments in a blind trust. That was so that I would avoid any conflicts of interest. That trustee indicated last week when he was asked about this, he said that he wanted to diversify the investments that I had. And for a while, he had money in a Swiss account reported in the U.S., full taxes paid on it, U.S. taxes. There's nothing wrong with that. And I know that there may be some who try and make a deal of that, as you have out publicly. But look, I think it's important for people to make sure that we don't castigate individuals who've been successful and try and, by innuendo, suggest there's something wrong with being successful and having investments and having a return on those investments. The Speaker, you've indicated that somehow I don't earn that money. I have earned the money that I have. I didn't inherit it. I take risk. I make investment. Those investments lead to jobs being created in America.